Good evening, friends. Thanks to all who are part of the session, and thanks to that lovely time of worship by Anthony Sagairaj. So today's topic will be in continuation of what I've been speaking about over the recent two sessions. The theme is still the same, going to the foot of the cross. And in today's session, I'll be presenting three reasons why we fail to enter into mental prayer. Three simple reasons. And towards the end of the session, I'll be stressing on this aspect and asking us this question. Have we developed a one-on-one connection with the crucified Lord? It's so important. There are some things in life which, you know, we can ask others to do for us, but there are some things in life which we need to do ourselves. So for the benefit of those who missed out on the first two sessions, let me do a quick recap of what I spoke then. In the first session, we reflected on the importance of encountering Jesus at the Holy Mass. And this question came up. Have you encountered Jesus at Holy Mass? Then we delved into this topic about the Passion of Christ, connecting the Holy Mass with meditating on Jesus' suffering. The two are totally inseparable. They go hand in hand at all times. I shared 5 points of how we can benefit more from the Mass. Point number four was so critical. Point number four was the exhortation and encouragement that we go to the foot of the cross. And we need to be present at two altars. The first altar, of course, is the physical altar at the church or the chapel that we are in, the altar that we see with our physical eyes. The second altar that we need to be present is through our spiritual eyes, the real altar where the lamb was sacrificed. So there are two altars. St. Alphonsus Liguori tells us meditation on the Passion of Christ yields many benefits and is very profitable to the soul. I list out some of these benefits towards the end. And it all happens through deep personal prayer. So in part two, we spoke about the prayer life and we challenged ourselves again with two big questions. We challenged ourselves with these questions. What is the quality of the prayer time that you and me are having with God on a one-on-one basis, apart from all the community stuff, apart from all the intercessions, praise and worships, devotions? When we're alone with God, what is the quality of time that we are spending with Him? And the second question is, are we allowing all our vocal prayers to move us into that realm of mental prayer, that deeper state of prayer that the Lord is calling us to? I mentioned that Pope John Paul had given us some direction on the rosary, and he mentioned without the contemplative dimension, the rosary can be meaningless. So in connection with this, we spoke about the layout of the Temple of Jerusalem, the three zones, outer court, inner court, and the Holy of Holies. The Holy of Holies was where the presence of God descended. But people were not allowed there. Only the high priest was allowed there. But because Jesus died, and when he died, the curtain, the separator, which was torn from top to bottom, allowed everyone to enter into that Holy of Holies. It's conceptual. Today, God is calling each of us into that realm of prayer, into that intimacy with him. So this curtain represents the body of Jesus. Stone curtain, torn body of Jesus. So that's the parallel here. Torn curtain allows people to enter into the inner court, into the Holy of Holies. Torn body of Jesus allows you and me to enter into that intimacy with the Lord, with God the Father. So keeping all this in mind, there are a few dots to connect. Holy Mass, getting to the foot of the cross, reflecting on his passion, all are connected. Then the deeper aspects of prayer life, again connected to Jesus' death and the foot of the cross. So keeping all this in mind, let's move on to part three. Somebody asked me some time back, aren't you taking all this too seriously? Like, what's the point of talking about all the stuff, this Holy of Holies, Passion of Christ, delving into sufferings? Why can't you keep the faith simple? Why do you want to complicate matters? Why do you need to take it so seriously? It's a very interesting question. In my understanding, we just can't take this topic seriously enough. It's a matter of life and death. The Lord gave up his life for us. He paid for our sins. How can we not take it seriously? It's a matter of life and death, not only in context of Jesus' life and death. It's in context of our own life and death and our eternal life too. We can't take this topic seriously enough. And the benefits that come from delving into the Passion of Christ are so immense. We will look at that later towards the end. In Faustina's diary, here, if I read, I'll be reading from number 948. Towards the end, and she writes this: when I see Jesus tormented, my heart is torn to pieces and I think, What will become of sinners if they do not take advantage of the passion of Jesus? What will become of sinners, like you and me, for example, right now? And she says, what will become of sinners if they do not take advantage of the passion of Jesus? It's not a worldly type of taking advantage. It's something desire and on the heart of God, the Father. So back to the first quote, which we mentioned in part one, Francis de Sales says, Mount Calvary is the academy of love. What is interesting to note is Mother Mary, whose example we are supposed to be following, enrolled in this academy. She was at the foot of the cross willingly. She was not forced to be there. And through that pain and through that torment and through that suffering she endured and seeing her son die in front of her eyes, she got trained. In a way, she got spiritual training to fulfill roles which she's playing in our lives today. Two roles I can list right now. One is spiritual mother of the church. Two, very, very, very powerful intercessor. And if we are following in her footsteps, taking her as an example, we too need to get similar training. Of course, we are not called to be a spiritual mother or father of the church, but we are called to make disciples. Matthew 28:20, Jesus said, go and make disciples in all nations. And we may not be called to reach that level of intercession that Mary, the mother, was trained to reach, to fulfill her role. But all of us are called to be intercessors in the kingdom of God. The universal call to intercession is in 1 Timothy chapter 2. And we need to stand in the gap and start praying for people in need. This is what God wants from each of us. And this happens in the Holy of Holies, effectively. It can happen anytime and anywhere. In the Holy of Holies, it happens effectively. And this is where our intercessions and our prayers reach the heart of God the Father.